الخلوة نوايا العزلة نوايا الرياضة نوايا السلوك لله تعالى العظيم في هذا المسجد. مدد يا رجال الله أعينونا بعون الله وكونوا عونا لنا بالله عسى نهضى بفضل الله. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. طريقتنا الصحبة والخير في الجمعية. Our way is companionship, goodness is in the gatherings of goodness. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد. عليكم السلام ورحمة الله. والمشايخ told us that just like مجالس السوء, evil, bad, egoistic gatherings of satisfying only the urges of the nafs, the ego, that people engage in all kinds of vices in them. As if you are in a majlis like that, it brings cursing on the person. It brings trouble for their soul. They may be thinking they're having fun, but you're in a gathering with people who are not concerned, to say the least, not concerned with pleasing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They're concerned with pleasing shaitan, pleasing their nafs, pleasing their hawa, temporary satisfaction they're looking for. But to be in the midst brings evil, badness, darkness into the heart. Covers our insight, so we can't. You attend enough of these majalis, you stop to be able to even know what's right from wrong after a while. And the opposite is true. مجالس الذكر, مجالس الصلاة على النبي, مجالس القرآن. People, especially when you're coming to be with people who are concerned with pleasing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it brings light, it brings takes us out of, removes the veils of darkness covering our hearts, and brings us into clarity, and gives us tawfiq to make the right choices, and so forth. Don't underestimate the power of dhikr. People underestimate the ability of the power of words. What is the difference? Now, what is the difference between halal relationships and haram relationships? Is that people say, in the name of Allah, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, I give you my daughter or my ala sunnatillahi wa rasooli, in the name of Allah. Huh? Just mentioning Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes a connection between a man and a woman halal relationship. And not mentioning it, the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, boyfriend, girlfriend, is haram. Listen. The difference is mentioning Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is dhikrullah. That's the only difference. And like that, so many things. كل شيء لا يبدأ بسم الله. كل ذبال لا يبدأ بسم الله فهو أبتر, حديث النبي. Everything of significance that you don't start with mentioning Allah, it is cut from barakah. This is Allah's world. It's His creation. He blesses whom He likes and curses whom He likes, and brings near far, takes far whom He likes and brings near whom He likes. It's His. This whole existence is His. So Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, Mulana used to say it's a sword of light. Bismillah, in the name of Allah. Dhikrullah. Qul isma rabbik. They say you can't make Allah dhikr, اسم المفرد اسم بدعة. You say, okay, Allah says in the Holy Quran, واذكر اسم ربك. And remember, mention the name of your Lord. Who is our Lord? Allah. Allah is saying, mention the Lord, name of your Lord. So if you can't say Allah, what are you going to say? In a majlis zikr. Say, no, no, you can say Subhanallah. You can't say Allah. But you can say Allah. قُلِ اللَّهِ. Say Allah. Holy Quran says. And now we are coming to Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad. Very important, the holiest days of the year. مستعيذ بالله والفجر وليالي عشر والشفع والوتر والليل إذا يسري هل في ذلك قسم لذي حجر. علماء التفسير, they say Allah is swearing here by the 10 nights, that those days and nights are the nights of day and nights of Dhul Hijjah. They are the holiest days of the year and nights. So like Ramadan, those who know, they know. May Allah forgive us, we are weak ones. But the people that know the value of these times, they don't waste time. They milk every second out of these 10 days. One day, just Arafah, that if you worship Allah imanan wa ihtisaban in Arafah, the day of Arafah, 1 year before of sin, 1 year coming. Not only the past it erases, it also, you have erasing the future sins. Okay? One night, one day. So who doesn't want that? Who doesn't want to spend his days and nights in dhikrullah, in salah ala nabi, in prayer, in these coming 10 days of Dhul Hijjah? Except somebody who is, yani, as much as one can. I know people work, people have to wake up early. But fight for, Qiyam al-Layl, make few rak'ats if you can't stay up all night. But make it consistently. Do some extra salawat, some extra awrad. If you have the day off, then if you can spend the night in ibadah, then do it. من الذي أولياء الله؟ عن سيدنا ابن عمر, he says, ما من أيام أعظم عند الله سبحانه ولا أحب إليه العمل فيهن من هذه الأيام العشر. There is no days better for Allah سبحانه وتعالى and the deeds that he loves most are those made in this day, in these days. And he says, فَأَكْثِرُوا فِيهِنَّ مِنَ التَّهْلِيلِ وَالتَّكْبِيرِ وَالتَّحْمِيدِ. Then increase your dhikr Allah, la ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar. Sayyidina Ibn Umar used to go into the, and Sayyidina Abu Huraira, they would walk, wherever they walk, they would make takbir, and then people would join them in takbir, they would make tahleel, and people would join them in tahleel. Allah. And it is said that these days have such significance. قال ابن حجر رحمه الله في الفتح, that's what he thinks these days is لمكان اجتماع أمهات العبادات, is because in these days all the forms of worship are combined in one, because you have the Hajj season, which you only have it in this portion, in these 10 days. And then you can engage in prayer, fasting, sadaqah, all of the above. Well, I was reading today, Azhar had some aqwal that on the first day Sayyidina Adam was born, on the first day of the Hijjah, Sayyidina Adam was born. عندي صار آثار وأقوال بنات أحاديث. But I got it from Azhar Sharif, so it has some significance and reality. And that on the second day, Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad, it was Sayyidina Isa, Sayyidina Yusuf, his dua was answered. On the third day, Sayyidina Isa was born. On the fourth day, Sayyidina Musa. And then Sayyidina Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم was given fath on the sixth day. 7 days is also significant. Many like this. But it is, yani, these are afar. What is known is because these are special times, is if you can fast all nine days, Bismillah. Yeah. If you can only fast Arafah and maybe the seventh or eighth day, Bismillah. As much as you can do, do in this time. We don't know if we're going to live another year. We say this every time, but it's true. How many people have passed away this year? How many people are passing away? Do we know we're going to have another day of Arafah? No one knows. So we must treat these days as if they are the last opportunity for us in this holy month. Inshallah, starting, we're having a program on the night of Arafah. I think the night of the 15th. We'll see when they announce the beginning of the year. And then, inshallah, we try to increase our gatherings in those 10 days. We have some programs. But also individually, have a daily, this is the importance of daily awrad. Now we have some new people here who don't know much about tasawwuf or tariqah or dhikr, but it's important to have a wird. A wird is something you visit daily, just like eating. We don't miss a day with eating. Every day, naridu ala al-ma'ida. Naridu ala al-ma'ida means every day with the table, the feast. So wird is from that. It's something you do daily, consistently if you can. Is you have a daily chore of tahleel, la ilaha illallah, salah ala nabi, istighfar, and so forth. That, you know, the mashayikh, they made these recipes ready-made for anyone based on a hadith, based on ayat. And they give them to the murid, to the students, and they say, okay, you do this every day. Whenever there's special times, but if you can't, outside those times, but do them. It develops that consistency. That the best deeds, khayrul a'mali adwamuha wa inqal, hadith al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The best deeds are the ones that are consistent, even if they're few. So usually the tariqas, different Sufi paths, you enter, they'll give you, they start you off with a small wird, yani, relatively small, depending on the tariqa. But usually it has a recipe of ad'iyah, istighfar, salah ala nabi, dhikrullah, like that you must do daily. And then the weekly gatherings. That if you are able to be consistent with that, you will see the fruits of that in your life. If we're able to be consistent with dhikr, we do daily our awrad, you will see the barakah and the clarity in your heart and your mind. You will see Allah will put barakah in your time. You will see these fruits because, again, you are daily remembering him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us to do as much as we can in these 10 days. May Allah accept our deeds. May Allah forgive our shortcomings and grant us tawfiq, success to do as much as we can. You have, this is the way to gain, why they give you these awrads? Because you are fighting without the awrad, without the dhikr, you are fighting a losing battle against your enemies. Without the protection of the adhkar and the awrad, and the prayers, if we can pray on time, then we have our four enemies will drag us. And you see people come and say, I'm struggling. I have this habit. I have this bad attachment that I can't leave. What should I do? On your own, you can't do anything. But with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you can do. If you have a weakness, ask Allah. As much as people give importance to shaitan, you say, A'udhu billahi min shaitan rajim, he runs, yakhnas, with mentioning Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also, for our nafs, to control our urges, for our habits, bad habits, and so forth, there are also adhkar and awrad that one does. So these adhkar, you are asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to support you, to protect you, like that. One hadith about Bismillah alladhi la yadurru ma ismihi shay'un fil ardi wala fis sama' wa sami'u wal 'alim, three times in the morning, three times in the evening. And it protects you from any difficulty in that day or from any affliction. So the one who recited this hadith was Sayyidina Uthman bin Affan. His son was one of the seven ulama of Medina. He's the one that narrated it from his father. And so he grew up into old age and nothing, he was always very healthy. So he was reciting this hadith and he was actually doing this wird, this daily. And one day he had a condition where he half paralyzed. And they asked him, he said, by Allah, on that day I forgot to mention it. He forgot, Allah made him forget, and he had that affliction. So don't underestimate the power of dhikr. وَمِنَ اللَّهِ التَّوْفِيقُ بِحُرْمَةِ الْحَبِيبِ بِحُرْمَةِ الْفَاتِحَةِ